Good morning, students. So hope you understood last previous class. We started with new lessons, that is nutrition and health, and we'll continue with that lesson. So today we'll see about protein, energy and malnutrition. So last class we saw the different types of nutrients: carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamin and minerals. So we'll see what will happen if we have certain amount lack in our diet. So first is protein, energy, malnutrition. So due to the lack of this protein in our diet, they cause the disease called kwashiorkor and marasmus. So this will affect only the children. If you take kwashiorkor, it affects the children below 1 to 5 years old, and marasmus within 1 year. So if you take the symptoms of kwashiorkor, they have swollen limbs and legs, and the potted belly, the stomach will be enlarged, and the mentally retarded children. If you take marasmus, they will be completely lean, such as the bone is just like a bones, and without having any muscles they are grown. So this is between 1 year only. Clear? This is because of what? Protein deficiency, the lack of protein in their diet, only for children. So next we'll see what are the major sources of our daily. So we should take this amount of food in our daily life. So we'll see what are they. First one is carbohydrate. So if you take carbohydrate, we should take nearly 150 to 200 grams. This is the maximum amount we should take. And if you take protein, 40 grams. It is for daily life. And fat is 35. Understood? The maximum amount we have to take in carbohydrate form. Clear? Protein less than that and fat is less than that. So this is the major sources we should use in our daily life. Clear? Carbohydrate should be used much. You should know what are the food which consist of carbohydrate. You know, mainly all cereals which consist of this carbohydrate. Rice, wheat, all content consist of carbohydrate. Protein, it consists of milk and milk products and meat, egg. And fat, you know, yolk substance and oil substance which consists of fat. So these are the major sources in our daily life. Next we'll see about the vitamins, the types of vitamins. First one is fat soluble vitamins. There are four different types of fat soluble vitamins: vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K. So vitamin A, otherwise called retinol. Vitamin A, otherwise called retinol. And if you take vitamin D, otherwise called calciferol. And vitamin E, otherwise called tocopherol. And it is a derivative of quinine. So these are the types of fat soluble vitamins: retinol, calciferol, tocopherol and derivatives of quinine. So what will happen if we take less amount of vitamin A in our diet? So it used to cause the disease called xerophthalmia. Otherwise nyctalopia, otherwise called night blindness. So this is caused due to the lack of vitamin A in our diet. So it used to cause the disease called xerophthalmia and nyctalopia. So it is a problem which used to affect in our eyes. So we can't see the object at the dim light. It's called nyctalopia or night blindness. This is because of what? Vitamin A deficiency disease. Clear? And if you take vitamin D, calciferol, otherwise called calciferol, it used to cause the disease called rickets. It used to cause the disease called rickets. So it used to deform the bones formations. So those who have the particular disease, the bones will be it is not function properly. So they have pigeon chest, bow neck, and these kind of डी मैलफेशन ड्यू टू द बोन्स डिफॉर्मेशंस. क्लियर? सो द बोन्स विल बी वेरी वीक फॉर द पर्सन हु हैव लेस अमाउंट ऑफ वॉट विटामिन डी अदरवाइज कॉल्ड कैल्सिफेरॉल क्यूज टू कॉज द डिसीज कॉल्ड रिकेट्स. क्लियर? एंड नेक्स्ट विटामिन ई अदरवाइज कॉल्ड टोकोफेरॉल. सो इट यूज टू कॉज द डिसीज कॉल्ड स्टेरिलिटी. What do you mean by sterility? The person who not able to reproduce, they are N1. So reproduction will be reduced in animals such as rats, even in human being also if we have less amount of vitamin E in our diet. Otherwise called tocopherol. So next we see about vitamin K. So vitamin K otherwise called derivatives of quinine. So those who have lack of vitamin K in their diet, they cause the disease due to preventing of blood clotting. So normally the blood will be flowed, it is circulated towards the body. In certain cases what happens, if you have certain injuries, it should be clotted. So they have certain time limit for blood clotting. Understood? So those who have the disease or lack of vitamin K, what happens? The blood clotting will be delayed. So whenever you get any injuries, the blood will be flow from your body continuously and it will be clotted at a certain time. So the time should be very faster so that the blood will won't be lost in your body. So understood? Those who have this disease, the prevention of blood clotting. The blood clotting will be delayed in this situation so that the blood will be lost in their body. This is about vitamin D, otherwise called quinine, the derivatives of quinine. So these are the types of fat soluble vitamins: vitamin A, retinol; vitamin D, calciferol; vitamin E, tocopherol; vitamin K, derivatives of quinine. So the food, whatever they needed, it will be formed in this type of vitamins. So if we take vitamin and vitamin D, E, K, they have in certain food material. So we should find out the food material, what are present in certain food, and we have to carry, take it in our diet. So in your book, you have certain food sources. You should follow that in your diet so that we can able to avoid these diseases. Clear?
What water soluble vitamins? Water soluble vitamins are vitamin B1, vitamin B2, vitamin B3, B6 and B12. So these are called water soluble vitamin and vitamin C. We'll see the other name of this. First one is called thiamine. Vitamin B1 otherwise called thiamine. Vitamin B2 is called riboflavin. Niacin, pyridoxin, cyanocobalamin, and C is called ascorbic acid. So these are the other name of all these water soluble vitamins. So thiamine B1, riboflavin B2, niacin B3, pyridoxin B6, B12 is called cyanocobalamin, and vitamin C is called ascorbic acid. We'll see what are the deficiency disease of all these vitamin B1. So if you take vitamin B1, the deficiency disease is beriberi. So beriberi, it is cause disease in nerves and muscles. Nerves and muscles are not functioning properly because of this deficiency disease called beriberi. Clear? And if you take vitamin B2, riboflavin, so it causes a disease called aribo flavinosis cause disease. So they used to cause disease which is used form irritation of eyes, and certain rashes in your skins, and the corner of your mouth big fissures, the breakage. This region we can find the breakage and skin rashes. All this comes under this riboflavinosis. So it is caused due to the deficiency of what? Vitamin B2 riboflavin. Clear? And next we'll see about niacin. B3 otherwise called niacin. It used to call the disease called Bellagra. It used to cause the disease called Bellagra. So Bellagra cause nervous disorder. So nervous, the functioning of nervous system will be improper. Those person who are cause the disease called Bellagra. Clear? Nervous disorder. And next is pyridoxin. So it used to cause the disease called dermatitis. So dermatitis, they used to cause disease in skin, scaly skin, and loss of memories. So all comes on dermatitis. Scaly skin will be, it is not formed properly. It's very scaly. It is not thick. It is very scaly. Thin skin will be formed due to the lack of vitamin B6 called pyridoxin. Cause is called dermatitis. And next, vitamin B12, otherwise called cyanocobalamin. So it used to cause the disease called pernicious anemia. Pernicious anemia. So you know the anemia is a very common disease due to the lack of RBCs in the blood. So if they have hemoglobin, reduced hemoglobin in their blood, they used to cause this disease called pernicious anemia. Mostly this disease caused the female. Understood? It used to cause disease anemia due to the lack of red blood cells in the blood. So this is conditioned in B12 cyanocobalamin. Okay, next we'll see about vitamin C, ascorbic acid. So ascorbic acid, it used to cause a disease called scurvy. So here the scurvy, it is caused in the mouth regions. So bleeding gums, the gums will be bleed due to the certain deficiencies. Clear? It is caused by vitamin C deficiency. It's called ascorbic acid, cause a disease called scurvy. So minerals, there are, we have seen in last class about the micro nutrients and macronutrients, right? So if you take the macronutrients, the nutrients which is needed for our body in large quantity, that is called macronutrients. So depend upon the mineral requirement, there are two types, macronutrients and micronutrients. So if you take macronutrients which is needed for our body in large amount, we'll see what are they. Minerals which comes under maximum amount, first one is calcium. So calcium which is needed for a body in large amount. Next one is sodium. Sodium which is needed for a body in large amount. And next one is potassium. So these are macronutrients which is needed for a body in large amount. So you should know what are the food which consists of these minerals, calcium, sodium and potassium. So we'll see what is the use of and what is disease which comes under the this minerals. So if you calcium, it is useful for formations of bones. So you know a bone is one of the constituents of what? Calcium. So not only that, our mouth, teeth, it is enamel part. The teeth enamel part is made up of this calcium. So not only for this blood clotting and other thing, it is used, the calcium is used for that. And what is the deficiency disease of this? So calcium, as I said, it is useful for bones. So if the calcium is not enough in the body, means it is not sufficient amount, means it used to deform the bones. The bones becomes very weak and they get easily tired, and they get the problem from osteosclerosis. So osteosclerosis is the disease which comes in elders. So if we cross about the 40 to 50 years, they start getting the disease. The deep, it is not formation of bones. In Tamil, it is called elumbathaimanam, right? So they feel difficulty to walk up in a few distance. They feel tired for making or climbing a steps. So these are the conditions which is because of lack of calcium in your food. So next is sodium. So sodium, it used to maintain the fluid balance in our body, to maintain the fluid balance, and also the transmissions of neurotransmitter. What is neurotransmitter? The nerve cells can be transmitted from one place. They used to travel the impulses from one place to another, right? So this will be a function with the proper amount of this sodium in our food. So if you lack this sodium in your diet, so they used to cause the same thing. The nerves and muscles will be not function properly. So there is no proper locomotion of nerve cells in the body cells. Clear? So this is about sodium. And next is potassium. So potassium, same, it is useful for our body and to maintain the nerve cells, transmission of nerve cells and the muscles, muscle fibers. Nerve fiber and muscle fiber can be transmuted by using this. And if you not take proper amount of potassium in a diet, the transmission of nerve fiber will be lacked. So there won't be proper transmitter, the nerve impulses. So what is nerve impulses? What we are getting from outside, the stimulus, it will be reached the brain and brain will react to that stimulus. So this impulses will not transmitted fastly to the brain and get back the response. Okay, next we'll see about micronutrients. So macronutrients means which is needed for our body in maximum amount, that is calcium, sodium and potassium we saw. And next we'll see about micronutrients which is needed for our body in minimum, less amount. Understood? So here there are two types, one is iron and iodine. So iron, what's the use of this iron? Means it is useful for formations of hemoglobin in our blood. So blood, they need hemoglobin for transportations of oxygen as well as giving the red color to the blood. So that is the use of this hemoglobin. So if you take the insufficient amount of iron, so hemoglobin may increase. So those who don't have hemoglobin in their blood, they cause a disease called anemia. So mostly the girls, they get this problem called anemia. Clear? This is because if you have less amount of iron in your diet, you get this disease. So next, iodine. So iodine, mostly we get in seafoods. So they used for formations of thyroid gland. So thyroid gland is very much used, which is found in our neck region. And formation of thyroid gland, it is very much used. So personality development, it is used to secrete certain hormones like thyroxin hormone, and for that it is used. And so if you not have proper iodine in your diet, it causes a disease called goiter. So the swelling of neck. So these are the disease of deficiency of what? Iodine. Clear? This is called micronutrients, iron and iodine. So hope you understood today's class. The remaining part will continue from tomorrow. Thank you.